I am now going to show you how to use a business owner's existing phone number for missed call, text, back, and other SMS services in Go High Level. That way you're not having to get a new phone number, you know, go through this confusing process of trying to get them to change their phone number. You can use the exact same phone number that they have and plug it into High Level. Everyone's happy, everyone's less stressed, and you look better. Let's jump right in. So this is one of the most asked questions I get. It is, how do I do missed call text back if they already have a phone number? And the answer is you do call porting. Okay. Now this process is not the easiest, but it does work and it can be extremely powerful. That way you don't have to continually try to convince people to get new numbers. And it's just such a disaster trying to figure that process out. With this, you can use the exact one they have. So it's much simpler. So let me break this down, kind of explain to you how this works. So for missed call text back number porting, or just number porting in general, we would take the existing client's phone number and port it over from their carrier into Go High Level. Then once that existing number is in High Level, you can automatically do missed call text back or anything with SMS in Go High Level. It's like, it just cuts out all that and you don't have to go through that obnoxious process. And the thing is you can do this both for LC phone and Twilio. So you have that option for both of these. Now here's the thing, it will still need to get A2P verified. I'm not even going to lie to you. I'm going to be very honest. You will still have to get A2P verified. Everyone has to get A2P verified, just to let you know. Like, this is not a Go High Level thing. This is a worldwide FTC US government thing. You have to be A2P verified. This is incredibly powerful though, because phone numbers are extremely sticky. If you get someone's phone number, they'll stay with you almost forever. Like, it is one of the most sticky SaaS elements you can have in your package. You also can upsell very easily once you get the text message element down, because you have AI chatbots to use, you have automations, you have, you know, reputation management. It gives you a lot of leeway and will really keep your clients paying you way longer. So it is actually worth fighting for their phone numbers. Now, a lot of people, they're just trying to get those quick wins. They don't look past this. But like, if you have someone that wants to do missed call text back and the stuff in High Level, but they don't want to move their number, you should absolutely try as hard as you can to do a number port. Because if you can keep their number, the likelihood of them staying with you almost forever goes up significantly, because no one wants to keep changing their number. But if you can convince them to, it's huge. So now let me go into this process both on Twilio and LC phone. So the first thing I want to do is go and log into your Twilio account. If you have it, I'll go over LC phone in a second. But you'll come right down to phone numbers. Okay, you'll click port and host, and then you're going to do port A number. Oh, by the way, all of this stuff is just having to do with port. So when you start porting numbers, you'll see it all in these different tabs. But right here, we're going to click port a number, and we're going to go through a very simple process. So this process usually takes around 2 to 4 weeks. Sometimes it's faster. I've seen it done quicker, but it usually takes about 2 to 4 weeks. And in here, you basically have to go through this list of stuff. So if you don't know the Twilio's pricing page, because remember, you're switching carriers from either T-Mobile, AT&T, whatever you're doing, over to this, there will be that fee because Twilio costs money. But you basically want to go through each of these. So I will pay standard rates for my phone number and usage after the number of ports. Yes, check that. I must keep all numbers in service with my current carrier till the port is complete. Yes. I mean, it's yes to all of these, but I'm just going through them. I must configure my number in Twilio console before my number ports. Yes. I am responsible for termination change imposed by my current carrier for porting my numbers. Yes. I may be unable to receive messages for up to 3 days until the port completes. It says may be unable. Usually it's not, but this is just like a basic disclaimer, just being like, oh, you're screwed if you do it, but it doesn't really happen that much. It's just one of those things. Then in basic information, you're going to pick either residential or business. So if you're doing a business, you're going to pick business. You can add the port name if you want. You're going to want to put the company, the address, the city, the state, and the postal code all in here. Remember, that's of the business that you're bringing in, not of your business. It's the business you're trying to port over. Then down here, if they have any landlines, so that's, you know, the old fashioned, like plugged into the phone line, or toll-free numbers, which is 800. You're going to list all those right here. So then for your wireless numbers, which it most likely will be, you will put in the phone number, you will put in the wireless account number. So remember, if you're using T-Mobile, AT&T, Verizon, whatever it is, their business, even if it's a VIOP, whatever they're using, it will be their wireless account number. They all have them. You can use ChatGPT to give them instructions if they don't understand, but you're gonna need their account number. I see this all the time. People have no clue what this is. It's literally right in any carrier. They have it. It's your account number. You're going to put that in there, and then either the PIN of your account or the last four of your social security number. Remember, not yours, your clients. So once that's complete, you're almost good to go. You then need a letter of authorization and a billing statement. So let me show you what the letter of authorization looks like. This is literally just to verify. If they don't have this stuff, people can just go in and be like, hey, give me the number, and all kinds of scams happen. So this is just a letter you're going to need to submit, which is first name, last name, business name, address, city, state, zip code, and then the phone numbers that you want to port, your signature and the date and whatnot. So that's basically the way you want to put this. And again, with this, since you're a customer, you want to make sure that it appears exactly how it does on their carrier. You don't want any kind of mix up. If it's John, but he has his middle name on something, make sure it copies the exact thing over. So you'll need that set up. Once you have that done, you just need to basically put in a billing statement. If you do not know what that is, you can read it right here. All it is like the billing cycle. And then once you have the letter of authorization filled out, you're just going to choose the file. Once you have it, you're going to plug it right in. And then what you're going to do for billing statements is you're just going to have one of the statements, okay, the payment, you know, receipts of their old carrier in there, so they know it's legit. They can see to make sure it's all good. Once you put that in, you just click submit. It's all you do. You just go right through this. I mean, this is literally like a 5-minute process if you have the info. Actually, maybe four. Maybe even three if you're quick. It's so easy. You submit and then you do nothing. It's completely hands off from there. They take care of the rest. Now, what will end up happening is you will just kind of wait till you're back for them. But once it goes through, their number will go into your account. It will then appear under phone numbers in your Twilio account if that's what you're using. So that's pretty cool. I mean, that's a great way to immediately take their number and bring it in. And I just showed you how to do it. It's very, very simple and very, very straight. Forward. So now that you understand Twilio, I'm now going to explain how to do LC phone. So if you don't know, LC phone is the phone inside of Go High Level. This right here, it's their new phone system. It actually is Twilio. I'm not going to go super into this. It's like they are subcontracting through Twilio. Like it's been plugged in natively in High Level, but it's now LC phone. But you have the option. You need to go to Twilio or LC phone. And what you can do, so a lot of people hate Twilio. That's why they kind of like have moved away from it. A lot of people still have it from the old guard, so to speak. But if you're using LC phone, which is just the thing that's directly in High Level, this right here under phone numbers, under settings in a sub account or on agency view, all this is Go High Level's phone. So now all we have to do to get this to work is you need to reach out to Go High Level support at gohighlevel.com, whatever, and ask for a number port. There's no way in here or on agency view, I've looked and checked, for you to port a number. Like there's not like a port number option. You need to reach out to support and you need to say, I want to port a number, and they will give you instructions on how to handle that. So if you want to just go through LC phone, you will have to contact support and ask for them to do a port. And you just contact them either at those emails or on a Zoom or whatever and go, please let me, you know, port this number. And then you'll probably go through something similar to Twilio. So those are the two options you have, okay, where you go in, you submit all that info, just like I showed you earlier in the video. And then you have LC phone where you have to reach out to support to get the number to port. And again, what this is doing is this is taking their number they currently have and moving it under you. So you now control their phone number, but you can use it for missed call text back. You can use this for SMS campaigns, reputation management. I mean, the list goes on. AI chatbots is incredibly powerful. And I actually recommend that if you have someone that does want to do these services, but doesn't want to, you know, change their number, because a lot of people are like, we have to do missed call text back. We now need to change your number. If they don't want to do that, I highly recommend you do a port, because it just makes your service way more sticky. So that's really it. There is one more way, which is a hybrid approach, which is call forwarding and text forwarding. I actually do not recommend you do this because it gets super weird and you have to spoof phone numbers and go through this weird like blocking. And it basically takes their phone number on their carrier and it routes text messages and calls. So it's like, and it basically makes it look like they're sending it or receiving. It's kind of weird, but it doesn't really work for inbound. It's more outbound. Like it's weird. I don't recommend it. I'm only bringing it up just to show you that you can do text message forwarding and call forwarding. But I don't recommend you do it. It's just weird. It often runs into a lot of issues. And often it'll show their old number, even though it's doing the bounce thing. And people are like, what? There's two numbers now. So I just wanted to bring that up, but don't do that. I'm just showing you that that is a possibility to do call and text forwarding. It's really tricky. So I wouldn't recommend it. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. At the end of this video, I'm going to link a video to missed call text back AI powered. It's one of my newer videos. It's amazing. It is possibly the best video on missed call text back available on Go High Level. I highly recommend you check it out. It's amazing. It'll be linked right at the end of this video. So please watch it. So thank you so much for watching and watch that video.